Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Thoughts on Education by College Dunya. Today we are at MICA and today we have with us Professor Santosh Patra. He is the head of Media and Entertainment Management at MICA. Welcome to College Dunya Portal, sir.
Thank you.
So starting with the Q&A, my first question to you would be, what encapsulates MICA's MEM area, and could you give us a brief about the kind of courses, topics that get covered in this program?
Thank you. MICA's Media and Entertainment Management area probably is the only in the Indian B-School space which gives a width and depth of media entertainment management, business and education. It divides into three primary parts. We do have teaching in media and entertainment management area across all platforms. I'll come to in details. And we do a lot of research and closely work with industry in the space of media and entertainment management. And apart from teaching and research, we do undertake lot of training programs and consultancy services for the industry to solve the problem related to media and entertainment management. So let me go one by one. In media and entertainment management, as a department, it cut across multiple fields. And very recently, this year in fact, we have shifted the focus on media and entertainment to media, entertainment and sports business. Typically, what we cover in media and entertainment management, we cover primarily three things. Because many of you would be aware, media and entertainment today is not the same of media and entertainment before 20 years or even before 5 years. So what we cover in media and entertainment, it's three primary things. We cover content, the content business primarily, content management. We cover consumer, that those who use content and consumer business, and technology. Content, consumer, technology, prime focus of the media and entertainment management teaching at MICA. So if I go further, little deeper into that. So traditionally, content, when we used to talk about it, is used to be either print, radio, television, and all that content. But now content has gone platform agnostic. So when we devise teaching in the context of content business in India, we talk about the content business generated by textual, audio, visual, immersive, and all kind of experiential content as a part of media entertainment management courses. I'll talk about the details about the courses as well. Then second, when we talk about research, we do work closely with industry to see that what are the major problems media entertainment management and sports management industry is facing. So we take their problems, convert that to research solutions, and to give you some of the examples. Like recently we just completed a case on Indian streaming platform on MX Player. How the MX Player growth happened, how the consumer and the process of MX Player as a OTT business in India unfolds. Along with that, last four, five years, we have from 2018 onwards, we started India's first and only academic report on OTT business in India. This year, we have started another business report called India's Gaming and Esports Report, which is due to release in next 6 months. So we do a lot of training and research in this space. And third one, about trainings and consultancy, we do offer media and entertainment management as our online program and do a lot of industry and company specific training in the space of media, entertainment and sports business.
Thank you for explaining in detail, sir. Moving to our second question, according to you, how has the media entertainment management has evolved over the years?
Very good question. And in fact, I am in this space since last 15 years. So of course I can go before about that, I can talk about before that. Just in the last 15 years, media and entertainment has seen lot of ups and downs, and the way media and entertainment practice used to happen before 15 years and now it's completely different. To give the example, before even 10 years, when we talk about media business, primarily people used to think about advertisement business, because media run on the advertisements and primarily how the advertisement money comes and how it goes and what kind of result it gives. So before 10-15 years, that entire media and entertainment business and teaching was evolving around understanding four major platforms, that newspaper, radio, and television, primarily three. Of course, out of home and others would be there, that how they operate and who are their consumers and how they earn money and how that relationship between these media platforms and other industry works to ensure their advertisement running money. So before 10 years, all the courses were crafted around that. It will be like business of newspaper, it will be management of and business of television and in this segment, and media planning. That media planning, when we talk about different kind of media data used to be there and how to do the plan around that. In last, and I have been with Michael last 11-12 years, and in last 3-4 years, I have seen it shifted completely and taken a new direction. Neither consumer remain the same, nor the media platforms remain the same. Nobody now is talking about that only newspaper business or only television business or only radio or digital or only digital. It's now a platform agnostic business. People are like the generation, those who are consuming content, be it media content or be it entertainment content, they are least bothered about which platform they are consuming. So hence, when consumer shifted, when technology shifted, and when content consumption shifted, so our responsibility to create a new teaching era need to be there. So we have seen industry shifting accordingly with the consumer and technology. So we embraced that in the form of teaching in the media and entertainment space at Mica. And I'll give you examples. So now we are no more talking about the traditional way of media and entertainment business. We have shifted that to specifically what are the changes embraced by the industry. We are talking about in 2023, we are talking about the media content business, both of course subscription and advertisement, because it has taken subscription grew to a lot and people started paying, and how advertisement started being monetized and ROI being mapped. It's no more that you are giving the advertisement and you are waiting that something good will happen. Now every penny spent needs to be monetized and measured. So three major things happened. So lot of technology related courses got into the Mica Media syllabus. Lot of platform analytic courses got into Mica syllabus. And along with that, lot of new platforms of media business evolved other than digital. Digital is, I believe, is becoming ancient nowadays. It's getting into immersive. It is getting into multiple experiential platforms. So some of the, just to name few, some of the courses we also added in last couple of years, and this year we have added 4 new courses. Along with all the traditional media business courses, media research, media planning, and media platform, television, radio, and film, out of home, music business, we have started a course like fandom and community building management, because fan and community is becoming a major way to monetize in media and entertainment business. We started a course on sports business, which will not really talk about sports marketing, which will talk about 360-degree approach of sports in general, like IPL. It's the second biggest, largest sports property of the world. So we have a specific sports business course. We have a course on business of streaming platforms, which is, can be OTT in India or any streaming, audio, visual, or game streaming, any streaming business in India. We have started a course called Media Platform Analytics, where to understand consumers, consumer engagement, and give the ROI on that. We have started a new course, a new platform course called Business of Gaming and Esports. And accordingly, also we have started last year a course called Business of Immersive Technology in the context of media and entertainment. And other than all existing courses, these are the new bouquet of courses we have started offering to our students. Hence, they will be ready once they are graduating from in Mica with a specialization like media, entertainment, and sports, that they will go to industry and keep the work going without waiting for 6 months to get trained on that.
My next question was almost you had answered the. So my next question was, how do you ensure students who opt this specialization become the industry?
Very good question. So though partially I have answered it, but let me give you a context to that. So this area, Media Entertainment Management Department of MICA, and what the specialization we call Media Entertainment Sports Business Specialization, primarily what we do every year, like I told you that we offer around 250 to 300 hours of teaching those who go for the Media Entertainment and Sports Business Specialization. So how we reach these 250 hours of the course? That every year we have a academic and industry advisory committee which comes encompasses it all in our website with the top media entertainment and sports companies of the world. You talk about traditional from television to you talk about digital, you talk about social media. So there are around 12 to 15 top global leaders in media and entertainment. We constitute an academic advisory body. So periodically we meet then and understand what are the biggest disruptions, change and opportunities in the media entertainment and sports business. Mind you that they are going to be the people, those who are going to recruit our students to work for them. So every periodically when we evaluate, we take them that see that these are the courses every year we are teaching. And is there anything you feel that it's becoming redundant, or is there anything that you think that you are not getting resource on that and you need the skill set on this? So with a very rigorous process on to understand what is happening within academia, what is happening within industry, and where is the gap. Once we understand that these are the gaps, these academic things becoming not so relevant to industry, and these are the required industry not in academia and not existing in academia, we create a roadmap that we create that these are the maybe 50 skill sets, knowledge required for industry, and we are only offering the knowledge which will address only 20. So 30 skill sets or nature of things which required is not there. So we work hard to talk about how that 30 kind of skill sets need to be part of the education which the courses we are offering. So we ask all these academic advisory committees to take lead on some of the themes and see that if they can work or they can connect best people.